In this illustration, we'll be discussing about the work done by friction on a sliding chain. Here we are given that a chain of mass M and length L rests on a rough table with one end is hanging over the edge as shown. The friction on table is such that chain starts sliding all by itself when x is equals to L by 3. And we are required to find the total work done by friction on chain till it completely slides off. Here we can see it starts sliding all by itself when its one-third of length is hanging. That means the weight of this one-third part exceeds the friction acting on the two-third part. So here we can write friction on two-third of chain is equals to weight of one-third of chain. Then only it will slide off automatically by itself. So here we can write friction on this two-third part of chain will be mu multiplied by 2 by 3 mg and this balancing mg by 3. So on simplifying here we can see mg gets cancelled out. The value of mu we are getting is 1 by 2. This is the friction coefficient acting between a chain and the rough surface of the table. Now in this situation when a length x of chain is hanging and a part y is on table, then friction on table part of chain is, this friction we can write mu multiplied by the normal reaction acting on the part of chain which is lying on the table. So this can be written as m by l multiplied by y multiplied by g. This is the mass of the chain which is resting on table, that is of length y. So it's weight multiplied by friction coefficient. So if we calculate the work done by friction when chain slides during a sliding of chain is, this work can be written as integration of dw, which is integration of f dy, if dy is the displacement when a length y is resting on it. So this will be integration of mu mg by l y dy, and it is integrated from 2L by 3 to 0 because initially the length resting on the table is 2L by 3 and finally it completely slides off. So on integrating this will give us mu mg by L multiplied by this y square by 2, and we substitute limits from 2L by 3 to 0 and this will finally give us the value minus because lower limit is 2L by 3. So this will be 4L square by 3. So this will be minus 2 by 9 mu mgl, and if we substitute the value of mu as 1 by 2, the work done finally we are getting is minus 1 by 9 mgl. That is the final result of this problem.